Hello, ladies and gentlemen, excellencies. It's a pleasure to share with you some thoughts on digitalization and multilateralism. As a member of the high-level panel on digital cooperation, mandated by Antonio Gutierrez, it is a pleasure for me to present some thoughts and perhaps also some concrete recommendations for the ongoing discussion. We all know digital technologies are rapidly transforming societies in profound and controversial ways. The transformation has the potential to make all our lives better, but also we see the risk that the technologies undermine trust between citizens, companies, and governments. The world urgently needs better ways of working together to shape all the impacts and find new ways of cooperation. COVID-19 is a good example to learn. So let me first begin with our element, which seems to be very important, and that's multilateralism. Multilateral diplomacy will be required also in the future to address issues raised by digital interdependence across national borders. Territory, borders, national sovereignty and physical space remain of profound importance in the digital age. Our individual lives continue to be lived in geography-specific, physical, legal, cultural, and socio-economic spaces. So while we must benefit from the internet's capacity to bring us together across borders, we also need to think carefully how we negotiate and regulate the ways in which it does so. Second, multi-stakeholder. Multi-stakeholder policy-making processes will be needed to reflect the fact that most of the digital world is run by a wide range of private and non-state actors. And it is also a fact that tech standards are established by a range of academic, professional, and international organizations. So, effective, inclusive digital policy will be impossible unless all relevant stakeholders are given a place at the negotiation table. This is not an easy way for many governments and states, but it's a must in the future world of digital interdependence. Third, multidisciplinarity. Multidisciplinarity approaches will empower us to think across not only geographical borders, but intellectual ones as well. Only by way of a silo-bridging ethos can we meet the challenges of the tech world of the 2020s, challenges like climate change, the SDGs, or health issues. That's not easy neither, but it's very effective, it's creative, and no robots will have the capacity to bring also empathic and other values at the table. So it's also a chance for human mankind. Fourth, digital governance. We must, as governments, protect the rights, assets, and interests of citizens, companies and countries in the digital realm. Citizens currently have little affordable protection in cases of hacking or other negative impact. And also companies, especially small and medium-sized ones, have similar limited options in asserting their legal rights on tech platforms. For many questions, we must not invent a new system or have new regulation. Many of our systems developed over decades can be adapted and are applicable. We have some specific needs, but we must also rely on our agreed principles, agreed values, and existing regulation. On a multilateral level, this seems to me very important because we know we lose a lot of time when creating new bodies, new charters, new regulation. Existing international core documents might be old, like the human rights, But I think we can adapt them in a easy way. Perhaps we can have an internationally agreed agenda to begin with the core documents and then go across all international relevant regulation. Let me put one last element. These are cyber attacks. Cyber attacks, data fraud and data threats have ranked among the five global risks listed by the WEF. And indeed, the impact is crucial and the cost enormous. Every year, the private sector as well as governments have more costs and risk. It has become a real business. Here, I think we need also more international cooperation for the investigation, exchange of information, and help in concrete cases. Policy cooperation, also legal assistance and cooperation is not new. Also here, we can rely on existing forms of cooperation. But we should do it, and we should do it fast. Otherwise, trust in all these digital technologies will erode, and only some big tech giants and all these abuses will have the forefront and fortune. So let us begin with more cooperation. It's possible, and if we can help to have a new architecture of governance with more networks of cooperation, more platforms, more information we share together, then the internet is real a help and gives us better lives. Thank you.